Good morning, children. Welcome to class 8, Maths, chapter 9, part 3. Children, in previous class, we have already done up to exercise 9.4, and today we are going to proceed to exercise 9.5. In that, we are going to learn how to make the use of different identities in different examples. So let us proceed with exercise 9.5. The first example you see, children, here we have to find out the products making the use of suitable identities. Now we have learned already how to find out the products, correct? But here you see in this two different brackets, you can see the first one is x plus 3 and second one also x plus 3. So what are we going to do here, children? This is equal to x plus 3 is 2 times. So we are going to write x plus 3 whole square. It is 2 times. Now you should know now here which identity we are going to use. It is a plus b whole square. So all of you know that a plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So we are going to make the use of that identity here. So this is equal to, we are going to write the square of first term plus 2 into first term into second term plus second term square. So which identity we have used here, children? We have to mention that. That is a plus b whole square is equal to identity a plus b whole square. Okay. Now similarly, let us proceed to the example number 2. In this, they have given 2y plus 5 and 2y plus 5. Both the brackets have same sign as well as the same number. So here also, we are going to write 2y plus 5 whole square. So here again, we are going to make the use of the same identity, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square, children. So here you can write which identity we are making the use. You can mention it here. A plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. It is plus here. So this is equal to first term square, that is 2y square, children, plus, now can you tell me what are we going to write here? 2 into the first term, that is 2y, and then the second term, that is y, 5, and then the square of last term, that is plus 5 the whole square. Now remove the bracket. Can anyone tell me how to remove? Yes, 2y whole square. So square of 2 as well as the square of y also. So here we get the square of 2 is 4 and the square of y is, children, y square. Plus 5 2s are 10 and 10 2s are 20. So 20 into y is 20y. Plus 5 square, that is 25. Is it clear, children? Yes. Now let us see sum number 3. It is 2a minus 7 and 2a minus 7. Both the brackets, same sign and same number. So here again we will write here, instead of plus, you have to be careful. Now here it will be 2a minus 7 the whole square. So Ramesh, can you tell me which identity we are going to use here? A minus B now. Okay, previously it was A plus B. So naturally, here it is A minus B. And the formula of A minus B whole square is different from A plus B whole square. What is the difference? About sign. Very good. So this is equal to A square minus 2ab plus बी स्क्वेयर करेक्ट माइनस साइन सो इंस्टेड ऑफ माइनस बाय मिस्टेक इफ यू राइट प्लस चिल्ड्रेन देन योर आंसर विल बी रॉ करेक्ट सो इन मैथ्स यू हैव टू बी वेरी एक्यूरेट बी वेरी केयरफुल विच साइन वेर यू हैव टू मेक द यूज ऑफ विच साइन सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू मेक द यूज ऑफ दिस आइडेंटिटी दैट इज ए माइनस बी होल स्क्वेयर सो हियर वी विल राइट 2a whole square that is the first term then minus 2 into bracket first term is 2a second term is 7 then plus b square that means last term minus 7 the whole square this is equal to 2a square that is 4a square children minus 7 2s are 14, 14 2s are 28. So minus 28 and plus 49 because minus is there. So minus square or directly you can no need of writing then also it will come plus. So 7 7s are 49. So a square minus 2ab plus b square you get 4a square minus 7 2s are 14, 14 2s are 28, 28 into A, so 28 A and plus 49. Now we move to sum number 4. This is equal to 3 A minus half it is given children. Half the whole square. Okay, so 3 A minus half whole square, it is 2 times. So this is equal to first term square that is 3a the whole square minus 2 into first term. What is first term here? 3a. So we write here 3a then the second term is half and then the last term plus half the whole square. Okay. Now 3a square so every one of you know 3a square is 9a square so this is equal to 9a square minus sign as it is now how you will simplify this fraction is there so you can see here 2 and 2 you can directly cancel it okay so this 2 and 2 gone what is left behind minus 3a so here you will write minus 3a then plus 1 upon 2 square so 2 into 2 is 4 so 1 upon 2 whole square is 1 upon 4 clear children okay very good now let us see sum number 5 and this decimal is there so don't get afraid huh I know many time what happen when children see decimal or fraction you are frightened no need to get nervous 1.1m minus 0.4 and in the another bracket you see is the sign same in both the brackets no it is different so here which identity we are going to make the use of it a square minus b square is equal to a minus b and a plus b so here we are going to write which identity a square minus b square is equal to a plus b and a minus b this identity we are going to make the use of it in this example because instead of a suppose we see it is 1.5m and b is 0.4 so a minus b and a plus b so we will write a square minus b square now here a is 1.1 So this is equal to children 1.1m the whole square. Okay, have you understood? Which identity we have made use here? A square minus b square. Why we have made the use of a square minus b square? Because in one bracket it is a minus b and another one it is a plus b. Okay, so whenever a minus b and a plus b is given, then we are going to make the use of a square minus b square. So here we write 1.1 m square minus 0.4 the whole square. Now we have to find out 1.1m into 1.1m because it is square. So square of 1.1 is how much? First let me know that. So it is 1.21. Yes? So this is equal to 1.21. And the square of m is m square. So I will write here 1.21 m square minus now 0.4. So 4 square. 4 into 4 is 16 decimals. So 0.16. Okay, so isn't it? So if you work out the correct answer, you get full marks. Be very careful only about the sign. Okay, let us move now to the next example. In the next example, they have given us a square plus b square, and second one is minus a square plus b square. So this is equal to, I will write here, b square plus a square. I arrange the terms here, children. Okay, and here I'll write b square minus a square. So here again you see in the both the brackets, one bracket is b square plus a square, another one is b square minus a square. So which identity we are going to use? A minus b and a plus b. So a minus b and a plus b is there, then we are going to write is equal to what, children? A square minus b square, correct? So here they have given us b square. So we are going to write b square the whole square. Okay, it is already in place of a, it is given b square. So we are going to write the square of that. So b square the whole square. Then minus sign and a square, instead of b, here it is a square. So we write a square the whole square. Clear? Now let us remove the bracket, children. We get here b raised to 4 minus a raised to 4. Damn easy, no? Isn't it? Fine. Let us move to sum number 7. 6x minus 7 and 6x plus 7. Now I think everyone, the whole class will be able to tell me which identity we are going to use here. One bracket minus, another bracket plus, with the same terms. So this is equal to what? What shall I write? Which identity? A plus b and a minus b? A square minus b square. Very good. So first we will mention which identity we are going to use. A plus b and a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. Correct? So here we are going to write 6x the whole square minus 7 the whole square. Now find out the square. Square of 6 is 36 and square of x is x square. Very good. So this is equal to 36x square. And the square of 7 is 49. 7 into 7. Correct? Okay. Now second one after that is minus a plus c and minus a plus c. Both the brackets same. Two times. Repeated two times. So we are going to write the square of it. So this is equal to minus a plus c the whole square. It is two times, no, the same terms with the same sign. So minus a plus c whole square, two times square. So now tell me which identity now here we are going to use. A plus b the whole square, that is a square plus 2ab plus b square is equal to a plus b
the whole square.
Correct, children? Fine. Now let us remove this bracket. This is equal to, the first term is here minus a, the whole square, plus 2 into. Now, have to be careful. 2ab. Now a, in place of a, they have given us minus a. Correct? So we will write minus a. And then, in place of b, here it is c. So we will write here c. Then plus b square. So in place of b, here it is given c. So we will write down c square. Now remove the bracket. Minus sign. So minus minus plus. So this is equal to a square. You know why we have written this? Because minus is there and that too square is there. So 2 times minus. Minus a into minus a. So that will give us minus minus plus a into a is a square. So plus a square. Then here comes minus sign again inside the bracket and outside there is plus. So plus minus minus. So I will write here minus 2 a into c is ac plus c square. Easy examples, no children? Yes, you have to practice at home. Okay, in rough book again and again. Okay, now let us see the next example, ninth one. This is about the tenth one. It has come here, minus 7b, that is tenth one. In ninth one it is x upon 2 plus 3y upon 4 and another bracket is x upon 2 plus 3y upon 4. 2 times the same bracket, children. Okay, so this is not here, this example it is. So x upon 2 plus 3y upon 4 and x upon 2 plus 3y upon 4. So a plus b and a plus b, both the brackets are same. So if both the brackets are same, we are going to write the square of it. Okay. So here the sign is plus. So no need to worry, children. Directly you write down x upon 2 plus 3y upon 4. Whole square, but you have to mention which identity you are making the use of it. Which identity you are you making use here? A plus B and A plus B is equal to what? A plus B whole square. That is A plus B the whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus b square. Okay, so same way we will apply here. This is equal to the first term square, children. So x upon 2 the whole square, then plus 2 into first term is x upon 2, then second term is 3y upon 4, and then the last term is plus 3y upon 4 the whole square. Okay. Now let us remove the bracket. The first term square is x square upon 4. Okay. Now you see, children, here what are we going to do? 2 and 2 directly we can cancel it off. So here we will get this 2 and 2 gone. 3x into y is plus 3xy. Correct? And upon 4. The square of 3 is 9 and square of y is y square. So we get here 9y square upon square of 4, that is 16. Is it clear, children? So this is our answer. Okay. Now the last one is 7a minus 9b and this b is here 9b. Now, which identity we will use? both the brackets same sign, minus sign. So 7a minus 9b the whole square. It is a minus b the whole square. Okay, so we are going to write a square minus 2ab plus b square, that is equal to a minus b the whole square. This identity we are going to make the use of it. So this is equal to first term square, children, 7a the whole square. Minus sign is there, I have already informed you. You be very careful whenever the minus sign comes. Okay, so minus 2 into a is what here? 7a, first term, and second term is 9b. Okay, and plus into bracket 9b the whole square. Is it clear, children? Yes. Now can you tell me how to remove the bracket? First term is 7a the whole square. 7 square as well as a square. So 7 sevens are 49. 49a square. Reena, are you able to understand, Reena? Yes? Very good. Now minus sign. Now multiply and tell me. 7 nines are 63. And 63 into 2. That is equal to how much? 126. 126 what? A into B. So AB. And plus 9B the whole square. So square of 9 is 81. And the square of B is, children, B square. Okay? So nice it was, isn't it? And easy examples. Of course, you have to be careful when you work out with the negative sign. Whenever the minus sign is there, you have to be very careful. Okay, just remember the identities, which identity we have to use and which example. Okay, children, so I hope all of you have enjoyed. Yes, now in the next class we will move further, children, and all of you work out all the examples in your rough book again and again as a practice. Thank you, children.
रिकॉर्डिंग नहीं हो रहा था ना पहले, हुआ भी कि नहीं हुआ?
स्टॉप स्ट्रीमिंग।
चलो मेरा वो भी लेना था 2 मिनट।